Welcome back to part two of this Scriptcase demo video. During part two, we will continue with pdf.js and Scriptcase. Now, what we previously did is we had already created our grid application, but also added an iframe to view PDFs, which are being generated using the pdf.js library. And we have also added an edit button with a form where we can upload our PDFs to our grid application. So what we had also started previously was the option of adding an alternative viewer for the PDF, which is using the typical or default rendering engine of our web browser. So here we had removed the toolbar and placed this within an iframe within the page. So now what we're going to do is we are going to expand on this a little more. We will copy some of our applications and make some slight changes to how this all works. So within our grid application, so if I run that again, we are at the moment viewing the PDF only within an iframe here. Now what we want to do next is add a link for the PDF to open the PDF viewer which we had just created. We want to make some further changes to our PDF here, as well as add an extra button here so we can add new entries into this table, as in add further PDF documents which we can then upload. So if we return back into Scriptcase and first of all open our grid application, and the first thing I will do is I will go ahead and include a new button here to add the form which we had previously created and add that within our toolbar here on the left hand side. So if we access buttons within the left hand menu and the type, we want to select link, and here for instance I will say add PDF, let's call this button add PDF, and click create. Okay, so I will also go ahead and change the style, kind of like the blue add PDF. We could change this to red or any of the preset standards or styles that we have here. For instance, danger. We have our label, we can add a hint and so forth. Now, the most important part is we want to add our link. So we have here the form which we have previously created. If I select next, it will specify or allow me to specify the parameters, which there are none, as it is a new entry that we want to add. I'll click confirm and select the link operation mode, which is where the form will open within a modal window. Now here we can specify the height as well as the width and click then the save button. So now within the toolbar, I will also go ahead and move that add PDF button to the left and then run our grid application. So now within the grid application, I now have the exit button and the add PDF. So exit is already red. So let's go ahead and change the color of that. So select the button again, and we can then change here an alternative look. Again, I'll select the PayPal, generate that. And then next time I load this grid application, the button will be blue. Okay, so then next up is adding the link of this to our new viewer. Now before doing that, we want to make some changes. So let's go ahead and close each of the applications we have open right now. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy the viewer, blank PDF view global. Okay, and then I'm also going to do the same with the previous PDF hello world we had created. So if I'll copy that, and here I'll now call this blank PDFJS and also global glob and go okay. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and open both of these and open our grid application, which we will do a little later once we're ready. So we're in the PDFJS globe, which is the original hello world, which we had created and started to modify. So here we are using the pdf.js library, and we want to change the Steve Jobs here to actually open the file which we have uploaded instead of a specified file here from our library. So if I add a new line, I will comment out this option, and then in here I'm going to specify the full path which we had used previously, scriptcase9/file/doc, so the folder where the files will all be uploaded. And here then I will also specify a global variable. So now with the global variable, once I have the blank application saved, I can then go ahead and run the blank application, and it will request the global variable where I can specify Steve Jobs PDF, which is a file we had previously uploaded, and it will then be opened. So now we will need to change this within the grid, which we will come to. So when the grid requests this actual blank application, it will search for our file within our folder from those which have been uploaded. Now within the blank PDF view, we are using the standard HTML5 viewer of our web browser. So we have here within our PDF viewer, if I run that again, we have there our default PDF viewer using the browser renderer. And we can actually change that to use a viewer which is available within the PDF JavaScript library. So here if I open again the external library and then view the files that we have here within PDF.js, we have here the web folder and we have here the viewer.js, which we can also use. There's a demonstration example here, viewer.html. But we can actually use this viewer.js within our document. So the first thing we'll do is we will comment out the iframe again, and this time we will load the viewer in here. So if I paste that in here, we have then an iframe. Again, we're specifying the source, and this time we are indicating the full path to the library and indicating the file, and then also the global variable which defines then the PDF which we shall open. So now if I go ahead and run that again, we'll see that the PDF view is now slightly changed. And we have the PDF.js actually now managing the view action of our PDF. So now back into Scriptcase, we can now close the library. And let's now copy our grid application. And this time we can call it viewer, grid viewer for instance, or any name we please. And I will go ahead and open that, edit it. And we now need to change the application links to our two new applications that we have created. So we have here, first of all, the grid viewer, which is, should now be the PDF view grid. Sorry, did I select the wrong one there? So form, here we have the hello world. So if I change this to our PDF view, and here we have blank PDF global. And if I go next, we can now specify the global variable, which is then essentially the file, and confirm. And we now have our links. Now, if I run this again now, let's just confirm that it is working. And now within the grid application, I should be able to view the PDF, which is then generated that we have uploaded to our files. Remember, we added the add PDF here to add our form, where we can then upload any PDFs we want into this database. Okay, so the next thing we want to do is change this link. So this link will actually open the alternative view which we created. So let's select within the grid application, application links, create a new link. And here we will select the field link and indicate the field PDF. Click next. And this time we'll select the PDF.js glob and select next. Again here we indicate the PDF, which is then the global variable, confirm. we can select to open in a modal window or another window. So I will select modal and present a width and a height and select save. Now if I go ahead and run the application again, our grid application will now have the links which will open a modal window of one of our options to view the PDF. And we don't have an exit button here now, so it's possibly better to have the alternative view here. So let's run this again, check our other link, and see that that also opens our application. Okay, so within our PDF application here, we may want to add an exit button. So let's see if I have a code snippet for that available here already. I have here the option here, close modal. So let me paste that in here and see what that brings us. So here we have a function and a button. So I could leave that as it is now. Let me just run that and see what happens. So we don't have to move, adjust it around anywhere else. And there we have a parse error. So here we have a mistake somewhere in the code. So let me just go ahead and copy the function, the script then, into our header. We can actually remove the PHP open and close tags here. Move the button, place it here, and then run our window or our application again. So now we enter the global variable and we now also have a close button. Okay, so now if I run the grid application again and go run, the grid, the view now has a close button, which now also closes the modal window. So now here we're using a basic function, close window, targeting the window parent and to remove. And then we are specifying the button, which we are using the close modal, JavaScript close modal option here, which is the function we have defined here. And that presents us then a button to close the modal window. Now we don't need a close button here for our other PDF, which is then within the page. Of course, we can reverse the two around, have one or the other displayed here as we so please. Okay, so now that we have our viewer added to both the links, we have our form added. Now the only thing I'm feeling that's missing here is actually the button to view this PDF. So let's go ahead and modify the form application. And opening the form application, we can add a new button in here. So let's go ahead and select new button. And we are going to say view PDF. And this is going to be a PHP button. And select create. Now within the code, we are going to define a variable or a function, should I say, view PDF. And open and close those brackets. Now for the view PDF, we want to create an internal library and we can then replicate the features that we've added already. So opening an internal library, and here I will select the project, and then within the project I will create a new library. Now here I will define then function view PDF open and close our statement. So now I do need to add the open PHP here. Open our PHP. Then we have the style of our function, we need our first tag, and then we can close and reopen our PDF again. And just by copy pasting here a little bit faster. And there we have our open and close tags defined. Okay, so now what we want to do basically is copy the application we have created here within the blank application. And we are going to basically copy this into our internal library. So if I come all the way up here, copy this whole page into our internal library, and then I can paste that within our options here. So now within our application, so we are already using the library files which we have defined, and we obviously can keep using those, or we can actually use the actual scripts, whichever is easier. So let me just go ahead And what I'll do is I'll use the actual scripts here. Let's remove this. Use the actual scripts. So using the local one. And we will actually keep using the library files which we have indicated the worker. However, we will change to the original. So let me change that back again. We have here also our variable for the file which we're downloading. So we'll leave that as it is, so requesting the PDF global variable which we've previously defined. And we should then be able to save that. So now within our form application, we now need to also select that internal library. So selecting programming and internal libraries, we should have here the library defined, which I didn't add a name to, would you believe? So let me create a new one again, indicate the file name, view PDF, we paste the entire code in here that we have just created into our quick function, paste that in there. We can then go ahead and save that. Now I'll delete the first one, which was a mistake. And now within our form application, if I select the programming libraries again, I now have the internal library that I had previously created. And now if I select that and run the form application and then click the View PDF button, it will now open the PDF which has been selected. So here I can go ahead and click the close button, which we previously added, or click OK to return back to the form application. Okay, so exiting the form will of course in general take us back to the grid application if we have it running. Otherwise, it will take us back to Scriptcase if we have just run it. So if I now run the grid application, I click Add PDF, I select to view the PDF that is there. I can then also go ahead and close the modal window or select OK at the bottom of the form. So just a quick recap over everything that we've done in the last two videos. We have created multiple view applications for viewing the PDF in various methods. We've used the browser rendering method as well as the viewer JavaScript, which is included with PDF.js, as well as the standard rendering library. Don't forget you can download this here at PDF.js, which is located with GitHub. We've copied all of the examples from the website and pasted them and used them directly from this JavaScript library within our Scriptcase applications. So here we have then essentially created a grid application which allows us then to view the PDF in various ways, as well as a form where we can then upload our PDFs and also view them within our Scriptcase application. I hope that you've enjoyed this video. I look forward to seeing you again. Thank you very much for watching. Have a nice day.